Hey everybody, so today we're reviewing the A Return Tops 69 Yo-Yo, or VIIX, and I just recently picked this up. I got it in the mint colorway, which I thought it was going to be blue, but it's actually like a really nice green color. It's more of like a winter green type mint, which is really nice. I really like it. And I just thought I'd give it a review because there's only going to be around 100, I think, that they said. 100 of these made, and they only released 50 so far. So the other 50 are going to be released by Old School Throws. This was a collaboration between Old School Throws and A Return Tops. Forgot to mention that. And, yeah, I just want to get this review out for anybody that's on the fence about getting one. You should definitely try and get one with the next release. This thing is awesome. And so, real quick, some of the specs. I don't really have them in front of me right now, but off the top of my head, the weight is just under 64 grams. I think it's 63.7, so just under 64 grams. The diameter is around 52 millimeters, so it's a smaller yo-yo. And the width is, I believe, 45 grams. I'm not sure, but it'll be in the description of the video if you're interested. But it's definitely on the smaller side, which I like. I really enjoy smaller yo-yos. But it's got a nice classic shape, but it also has a nice modern twist in it. So it's really old school, but it has a modern twist. So real quick, let me show you what I'm talking about. It's got a nice old school throw type shape, like the nice organic shape, but it's got some new school vibes in it. You know, some new school, that new school width. Because all of those yo-yos back in the day were around 40 millimeters width. This one's easily 45, which is pretty cool. And the shape is really classic. It's basically, in my opinion, the shape is in between a woolly marmot and a peak. Like, it's the middle brother of the woolly marmot and the peak. So you got the woolly marmot, which is super undersized. This, which is more like a mid-sized throw. Then you got the peak, which is just a little bit bigger diameter-wise. But the 69 beats both of them by far with the width because it's a newer modern yo-yo. It also has that little groove in there to stop some string friction and very low walls compared to the woolly marmot and the peak. So, yeah, just to compare the sizes, I have with me a woolly marmot and a peak 2. I don't have a peak, but I have a peak 2, which is close enough. So all right, so here is the 69 next to the woolly marmot. This is a woolly marmot 1, and as you can tell right off the bat that there is definitely some new school vibes going on with the 69, but with a similar shape. Where the woolly marmot has very high wall and no recession to stop that friction near the response pad, the 69 has both of those things. Aside from that, they're both a similar shape. You can tell right here, this is to compare the diameter. You can tell the 69 is a little bit bigger by about a millimeter or so. And I'm just gonna flip these over so you can see the width. And as you can see, that's definitely a lot of width that's different between the woolly marmot and the 69. And this isn't a bad thing. I actually really like this width, because it makes it hitting some tricks really easy and it feels really effortless. Similar to like if you were to play an edge. If you have an edge, it's around the edge's width. And here we go. We're going to compare it now to the peak 2 right here. So here are the diameters. Definitely, the peak 2 definitely has some size on it. About the same difference as between the woolly marmot and the 69. But the shapes are a little bit different. I think that the shape of the 69 definitely resembles more of a woolly marmot type shape. It seems a little bit more rounded, whereas the peak seems a little bit taller, if that makes sense, like a taller rim. So more like, I don't really know how to explain it, but it definitely just feels like the 69 has a little bit more rounded, more organic type shape, and the peak 2 has more of that like new age H shape, if that makes sense. So think like the MMC type shape or a one drop cabal type shape. I think that the peak 2 has a similar shape to those, whereas the 69 has more of an old school rounded type shape. end to compare the width once again.
About the same difference between the woolly marmot and the 69, so it's about the same width difference between those two. So yeah, now we're going to take it apart real quick and show you what's inside. I know I mentioned before that it has a similar width to the edge, and as you can see here, I just grabbed mine really quick just to compare. The width is pretty much identical. I think the edge beats it out just a little bit, but it's hard to tell. Yeah, it looks like the edge has a little bit on it, but I just wanted to give you an idea of what kind of width you're dealing with. But the diameter is a lot smaller. The edge is at around 55 or 56 millimeters, I think 55. So as you can see, there's definitely a bit more diameter. So it's a smaller yo-yo, but it has a really nice modern width that makes it extremely fun and different to play with. All right, so here's the 69 taken apart. As you can see, it looks like they can fit a snow tire response groove. It's definitely a little bit thicker and it seems to be really deep, which I like. I really like really deep silicone recesses, which is awesome. A small axle right there, it's very small. And it comes with a grooved bearing. I'm not sure which bearing, but it is a grooved bearing. I'll let you know in the comments. Spins a long time. It also has these grooves on the outside right here where I was talking about to help reduce the friction, which is really nice in a yo-yo. Pretty standard with most yo-yos today, especially with this O organic type shape. And yeah, it doesn't really have a thumb grind. But I'm pretty sure you could do finger spins on it. I don't really finger spin, so I can't comment too much on that. And also, this yo-yo, before I forget, this yo-yo was actually made in China, so this was not machined by One Drop like most art throws. This was machined in China by the Old School Throws manufacturer. But honestly, that doesn't really make a difference to me. And it shouldn't to you, because this is an amazing throw, and I guarantee you'll love it. So what we're gonna do now, we're just gonna plug it in and we're gonna play it. We're gonna show you what it can do. All right, so here we are throwing the 69 yo-yo, just for a review. So the first thing you're gonna notice when you throw this yo-yo is it's got a little heft to it. Like, it's actually, it plays pretty fast, but it lets you know that it's on the string, which I think is pretty cool. Something else that I really like, it has a very, very nice grind finish. Like, most China shops have a very nice grind finish, but this one's really, really nice. I really like it. It feels almost like glass, pretty much. It's really nice, extremely smooth. As you can see, mine came with no vibe whatsoever. One thing to note, when I first got it, the response pads were definitely a little bit thicker, so because the response pads are super thick, it required it to break in a little bit, so the string was rubbing up against the response a little bit. But as of right now, it seems fine, which is good. Something else I really feel like this yo-yo excels at is rejections. So I've been really focusing on hitting this rejection right here, this Ninja Vanish rejection a lot. And this yo-yo seems to really excel at rejections, which is good because I suck at rejections and I'm still working on them. So if you're working on rejections, this is a good yo-yo for you. So you can hit a nice rejection. The loops just go everywhere. It's really awesome. I really like it. And yeah, this thing's just a blast to play. I really like it a lot. The extra width that you wouldn't normally find on a smaller yo-yo really helps you hit a bunch of those tough, challenging string tricks. Really helps you hit a lot of the strings or the strings that you want to hit because of the extra width. And yeah, that's about it. Let's see what we can do. It's got a very nice gap width, which is good. Spins forever. If you haven't noticed, it spins forever. It's really, really nice. The smaller diameter feels really nice to play, especially when most yo-yos are a little bit, or are usually around 55 or 56 millimeters. It's really nice to play, just a little change in pace, which is awesome. And
Yeah, I'm sure it can move fast. I'm not really a fast player, so I can't really push it too much, but it's got a nice, relaxing feel. It reminds me of a faster playing punchline. If any of you older throwers or those of you throwers that have been around for a little bit ever played an original punchline, it feels similar to that, but a lot faster on the string. I feel like it plays similar because they can push more weight out with that extra width on the 69, which is awesome. So that's it for this review. I really love this yo-yo. I think it's an amazing yo-yo, and it definitely has that feeling of a regular art throw. Jensen Charles and the people at Old School Throws really outdid themselves. I really think it's an amazing yo-yo. And there's only going to be about 50 or so going out into the wild anymore. So there's only going to be 50 more. I heard that the drop's going to be in a week or so, a few weeks, just sometime soon. So if you have a chance to pick one of these up, pick it up. I believe it retails for $100. And it's money well spent, especially if you really want that old school feeling on the string. It's got a really nice feeling. And yeah, that's it for this review. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next video. Have a good day.